فتح القسطنطينيه خروج الدجال, that after the conquest of Constantinople, the next event which will occur would be Dajjal appearing in human form. Because the Great War does not take place in a vacuum, by accident, but rather the Great War forms part of a sequence of events which will culminate with the false Messiah emerging in human form to rule the world from Jerusalem and to then declare, I am the Messiah. He said, if you want to study the Great War which is coming, we say to you, you cannot study that subject properly unless you pursue it from the perspective of eschatology. And that is that when the Great War takes place, yes, as we see from the Quran, that there is going to be frightful consequences for most of mankind. Oh yes. But Pakistan in particular ought to be paying attention to the subject. It is my opinion that as soon as that Great War commences, an attack is going to be launched on Pakistan. If not before, at least at that time. And when the attack is launched on Pakistan, it will be to denuclearize Pakistan. And having denuclearized Pakistan, to then break up Pakistan into bits and pieces so that it can never again rise as a powerful force in the world. That unless they turn to the Quran, absolute certainty that they will fail. They will fail. Then, Mr. Prime Minister, I want you to know, if you do not know it as yet, because I understand you studied at Oxford, I want you to know that the curse of our Prophet is upon you and your government, upon the country. When you borrow that money from the IMF, then the curse of the Prophet is going to be upon you. And when you borrow money on interest, who's going to repay it? It's not the Prime Minister who's going to repay it. Not his ministers who are going to repay it. No, it's the people. They're going to repay it. If I am wrong, tell me I'm wrong. Come on and tell me I'm wrong. And if the curse of the Prophet is upon Pakistan, does Pakistan have any hope? Huh? When the Great War takes place? It is absolutely certain that Allah will be waging war on you as well, rather than helping you. Unless the government of Pakistan has the good sense to turn to the Quran for guidance. If you want to take Pakistan out of miserable poverty and destitution, you have to understand, you can't do it simply with charity. That's only temporary relief. And you cannot bring about structural change in Pakistan until you restore a free and a fair market to Pakistan. And if you restore a free and a fair market to Pakistan, you'll know that it is a free and fair market when Allah can now intervene and cause wealth to circulate through the economy. So the poor can become rich and the rich can become poor. So be careful, Mr. Prime Minister of Pakistan. I welcome this change in Pakistan. But I'm warning you from Birmingham that you cannot succeed without the Quran. We pray that Allah may bless all those who now turn to the Quran and study it, so that the Quran might explain the Great War which is coming.